林耀神父您好，请问那属灵父亲和母亲和教徒受洗时的教父教母又有什么不一样呢？
Hello from our Orthodox channel, and we are very glad to answer to some questions of our friends.
大家好，我们是台湾基督正教会。那今天要录制一系列有关属灵父亲跟教父母有什么不一样。So the first question about what difference with spiritual father and godparents.
Of course, it's a very, very big difference. Okay, the spiritual father, it is he who from the church has the, let's say, the authority of the church to guide somebody in his spiritual life.
所以属灵父母亲他在这个教会对于他的属灵子女，他会告诉他在这个灵性的生活上可以给他一个良性的指导。
So it is the spiritual father is a person who is from the church, who is from the clergy. Okay.
所以属灵父亲必须一定是要信徒，是属于教会的。
He is the priest who is supposed the people to confess and to give the spiritual direction, especially in the areas, the missionary areas where the people like in Taiwan, that the people they don't know the Orthodox Church, and of course to hear his confession, to give the proper spiritual advice.
那属灵父母亲他必须是属于教会的，他常来教会，他可能也许是神父或者是教会比较有智慧的人，那他也常常告诫。那对于属灵子女的在他需要灵性上面告诫方面，他会给他一个良好的指导。
So this, as I say, this is the appointed person of the Orthodox Church.He's a priest, okay, and this is the spiritual father. He gives the forgiveness of the sins, of course, from God, okay?
当然，如果他的属灵父亲的是神父的话，当然会听到他的告诫，也会在这一方面他的神职，那借着神的恩典来帮他赦罪。
Now,
about the Godfather.
Yeah. Now, what we say, Godfather.Okay, what we say Godfather, it's not some person who will give the spiritual direction to somebody.
那当我们在提到这个教父就或教母的时候，那事实上他并不是在给予这个他的这个子女一个灵性上的一个指导或者是建议。
I say this because practically we have in the past some problem in the practical problem in the church.Somebody, for example, because he brought a person here to be baptized and he was his sponsor, okay, he wanted also to try to take advantage of him and make him, you know, like, oh, you will do this, how you will pray, how you will do this. This is a very, very bad thing.
那之所以要澄清这个不同，是因为在实务上我们也有遇到，就是有人他可能引导某一个这个朋友，然后来到教会，然后协助他受洗，然后可是他之后却利用他的这个就是教父的这个职位，然后不是职位，就是教父的这个角色，然后就试着想要利用这一个受洗的这个信徒，然后告诉他说，哎，他应该要做些什么？那这样其实是很危险的。
The Godfather or Godmother.It is not the most important thing in a baptism.
是像教父母在那个受洗的这个圣事里面，并不是最重要的。
The Godfather or Godmother represents is the witness of the church when it is a baptism or a marriage, you know, things like that.
所以教父教母就好像是这个教会圣事的这个见证人，可能是受圣洗的圣事，或者是这个婚姻的这个圣事，他们是教会的见证人。
It is that the community, I mean the church community, okay, represented by this person, will help this person For example, they will buy for him some books. They will see if he is not going to the church, you know why. They will try to say, give him an icon or teach him a little bit Christianity, but not to interfere with his spiritual way.
那所以教父母在这个信徒的生活当中扮演的角色比较像是，比方说会买一些圣像画送给他啦，然后买一些灵性方面的书籍给他。那如果他没有到教会来，可能会去关心他。但是这样子的角色并不是完全不是像属灵父亲那样，是直接给信徒在就是他灵性生活上面的一个指导，那不是这样子。
He will, for example, this the godfather or godmother, you know, for example, he will say, oh, you know, do you know about Christianity? Do you know about the Holy Communion? What is this? And generally, to introduce generally the church, but not to interfere with how he will pray.
所以教父母的话，可能就是他还没成为信徒的时候，他可能会问他说，在这个对于神的信仰方面，圣山还有一些神学上面是否了解，那而不是说教导他说你该怎样来祈祷。
For example, they can say to him, "Oh, as a good Christian, as a good Orthodox, you must pray. Yeah, this is the different prayer books. So to your spiritual father to say to you, are you going to use this prayer or pray 1 hour or 5 minutes or you know?" Depends. This is not. So they just say to him, you know, this is prayer. You must pray. But how and how long and how this? This is up to the spiritual father.
所以他可能买一些关于这个神学上面的书籍，也许是祷告方面的对他有帮助的。那给他这样的书籍，但是至于要怎样来操练，就是实践这个祷告多少小时的话，那他要询问他的这个属灵父亲，因为他属灵父亲比较了解他的状况，他可以承受的对这一方面比较有帮助，他可以送他这一方面的书籍，但是在指导上要问他的属灵父亲。
Okay, so and it is a very bad thing. For example, the godmother or godfather, if he sees somebody, he doesn't come to the church, one, two, three, four times, right? Of course, he must take a small care. Say, why you don't come to church? Okay, if he's sick, of course, he say this.But if he sees that, I don't want to come anymore and this, he must say to the priest first to see and talk together why, how to approach this person, or why you don't go to the church, because I don't like this, I don't like this, you know, something. So it's only to help.
所以教父母的职责是扮演帮助。并不是指导他。如果他发现他的这个教父母的子女他并没有来教会，那一段时间没来的话，他可以打电话询问，或是去探访他说，问他为什么什么原因导致他没来，那他可以跟这个神父讲，那看怎样来协助他，而不是他自己想方法来解决。
I don't know. Did I answer the question, or maybe there is something to ask?
Yes. If somebody he doesn't know how open to receive the Holy Communion would be better. This kind of question, Godfather cannot.
Of course, cannot.
Cannot.
Of course, cannot.
You cannot say like in the tradition. Actually, we can receive maybe 4 times a year.
No. First of all, this is heresy to say this. Okay.Say this in Chinese.
就是我想问神父的是说，那比方说，那教友可能会有疑问说，那我应该要多久来领一次，就是这个基督的圣体跟圣血？那这样问的时候，那教父母可以回答说，依据这个某些人的说法啦，那可能就是一年领了4次啊，这样子，像这样子的回答是可以的嘛？那神父说，当然是不可以，而且这样的教导其实是异端的教导。
To receive, for example, the Holy Communion 4 times a year, this is heresy.
那就是说，你一年来这个，有一种说法是说，你一年只要领4次圣体就好了。这种说法就是一种错误的一种异端的教导。
Because you know why 4 years? This is punishment, okay? It's like punishment of the church to say you will not receive the Holy Communion. And you know, why four times and not five times?
Like
or not three times?
Like
what is this? You know,
is.
These are heretic things, okay?
因为像这样的说法，事实上对教徒，
From
对教徒来说
really.
这样的说法实际上就是从就是魔鬼来的，因为他事实上就是在惩罚教友，说哎你一年只可以领这么几次而已。那而且他也没有一种根据是为什么是四次呢？所以这样的教导是错的。
This is up to the spiritual father and to the person who confess and who depends, you know, to the how he is going on and the spiritual father will judge and.We'll see also the attitude of a person and his spiritual preparation.
所以像这样子，领受圣体的这个次数，事实上，教友就是要来跟就是神父跟属灵父亲来谈这件事。那这个属灵父亲会依照他的这个态度，然后依照他在忏悔或告解圣事里面表达出来的这个态度，那还有种种的这个他的状况，然后来跟他有一个就是有一个这个对话这样子。
Okay.